Abby Rautenberg. I'm an LSNA instructor and the director of the Global Scholars Program at the University of Michigan.
Hi, I'm Catalina Ormsby. I'm the associate director for the Undergraduate Research Opportunity Program and also a lecturer at the School of Social Work.
We'd love to share with you some tips that we have, some advice that we think would be useful regardless of what it is that you're facilitating. And the first tip that we have is about goals. We find it's really useful to have clear goals, learning goals in mind. I customize the debrief often. I customize what questions I ask, what I want to follow up on, even what supplementary materials I might share, depending on what those learning goals are for the session.
Another tip is about knowing who's in the room. Who are the students that are present? What are their identities? Have they have experience with these types of activities, or is this something completely new, new concepts, things that you need to go from the beginning?
Sometimes you have to think about what relationships there might be between people in your classroom. Are there conflicts or tension or ways in which the relationships of the people impact the dynamics that might come up when you're trying to lead these conversations? One thing that we find is helpful, in addition to just getting information about that, is introducing guidelines, either at the beginning of a session or at an intentionally designated time within the session. Guidelines can be helpful in laying a foundation so that students know how to participate in that particular conversation.
As a facilitator, it's very important to do your own work on identity. If students are asking you questions, you're not surprised by them, that you can anticipate and you know how much you are willing to share or how much you can share with the students.
And in terms of also thinking about identity, a lot of times there might only be one student in the class who has a particular identity. And because of the nature of these conversations, identity is really relevant. And it's important to not call on one student to speak for a group, to not tokenize them, to not put them on the spot or ask them to really speak for more than just their own experience. That can lead students to feel even more isolated, even though you're actually asking for their voice.
As you go through these activities, you might find different kinds of emotion present in the classroom. As a facilitator, you want to be aware of those emotions and have different techniques on how to handle those. As you practice these activities more, you'll gain more experience and you'll find different skills to help you through this process. It is important sometimes as a facilitator to mention those things and acknowledge those emotions to the classroom in general. Sometimes we need to check in with the students to see if we should move forward with the activity or if we need to take a pause. Sometimes some facilitators might decide to take notes and have the classroom do the same, to just take a break and try to say what was happening, what was the emotion caused, what was said that have a student be upset or perhaps emotional about one of the experiences that they were sharing.
And remember that the types of emotions that might come up and the conversations that might come up are very much related to who's in the room. And so in the videos that you're seeing, the conversations that come up are very much related to the level of diversity that exists in that particular classroom, which might be different from the diversity that exists in your classroom. And so consider, based on the demographic of your students, what types of conversations, emotions, or ideas might come up for you, and how you might tailor the questions you ask or your approach to facilitating.